We're in a new month.
Tuli mwezi mupya.
But we are continuing with what we started the other month.
Nenga tugenda kweyongerayo necho chetwatandika nacho mwezi
gwa. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We're continuing with what we started the other month.
Tujja kweyongerayo necho twatandika
nacho. You know the word of God is inexhaustible.
Ekigambo kya Katonda techikoma.
We can preach about one word for the rest of our lives.
Tuinza nokumala obulamu bwaffe bonna ku kigambo kimu.
So we'll continue to explore what we can receive counsel from the scriptures we read earlier.
Tujja kweyongera okunoonyereza okuwabulwa n'amagezi mu byawandiikibwa
bya twasoma. It was a month of counsel, it will continue to be a month of counsel.
Gwali mwezi gwa kuwabulwa oba kufuna amagezi.
Any other word that will come will still be counsel. Hallelujah.
Ekigambo kyonna kyonna ekinajja kigenda sigalanga kya magezi na kuwabulwa.
It is called counsel.
Kiyitibwa amagezi oba okuwabulwa.
Because you get what you need.
Kubanga ofunira ddala ekyo kye weetaaga.
Then you make up your mind.
N'olyoka okola okusalawo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then you make up your mind to believe.
N'olyoka okola okusalawo.
And to walk with what is there for you.
Gwe n'otambula n'ekigambo kye kiriwo okululwo.
So the first time I stood here.
Omulundi ogwasooka bwe nayimirira wano.
Was it here or the other side? And the first time in this the last month.
Omwezi ogwayita omulundi ogusooka.
We read from Genesis chapter 15.
Twasoma okuva mu lubereberye
kumi na tano. From verse 1 following.
Okuva ku lunyiriri olusooka okweyongerayo.
Up to verse 6.
N'okutuuka ku lwomukaaga.
And for those of you who have been following.
Kumwe ababadde batambulira
wamu naffe. We have been on verse 1 and 2 basically.
Tubadde tusinziira ku lunyiriri olusooka n'olwokubiri.
We are yet to progress to verse 6.
Tunaatera okweyongerayo mpaka ku lunyiriri
olwomukaaga.
Hallelujah.
But we thank God.
Naye era twebaza
Katonda. We may or we may not.
Tuyinza oba tuyinza
obutagenda yo. But the Bible says after these things, that's what the Bible says.
Naye Bible egamba nti ebintu bino byonna
nga. The word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision.
Ekigambo kya Katonda ne kijjira Ibrahimu mu kwolesebwa.
And said, fear not.
Nga kimugamba totya.
I am your shield.
Kuba nze engabo yo.
And your exceeding great reward.
Era nze empeera yesingayo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am your shield.
Nze engabo yo.
And exceedingly great reward.
Era n'empeera yo ey'amaanyi.
Then he said, seeing.
Nalyoka
gamba. He said, what will you give me?
Mukulaba niyebuza gona mpati.
Seeing I go childless.
Ngatonda basirina mwana.
So the first time I talked about the word came.
Ogwasokera ddala bwe nayogera nti ekigambo
kya. And we explored all what not all but most of what is there in the scripture about
Netugena nga tutema tema byonna ebyaliyo mu byawandiikibwa.
And we saw that everybody is a candidate for the word coming.
Fene tulaba nti buli omu wano agwa mutulube eryo ekigambo kujja.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It came to people who were angry, who were jealous.
Nti kyajjanga eri abayala n'abo abaali
n'okujja. It came to people who were just celebrating God.
Ekigambo nga kijjira abo abajaguza Katonda.
It came to the people who were disillusioned with life.
Ne kijjira n'abo abaali banyiddwa mu bulamu.
And all sorts of people.
Abantu ab'ebikula ab'ebyenjawulo.
And all of us.
Era nga fenna.
Are candidates of the word coming.
Tugwa mutuluba eri ekigambo.
Even now the word is coming.
Era ne kakati ekigambo
kikyo. Hallelujah. The word is coming, you make up your mind.
Ekigambo kikyo kijja gwe kola kusalawo.
Last Sunday I talked about the relation between thought and vision.
Sunday yaita twayogera ku nkolagana wakati gw'ebirowoozo n'okwolesebwa.
And I said,
era ne ngamba,
the scriptures say,
ebyawandiikibwa bigamba,
that the way you see your life
nti gwengeri gy'olabamu obulamu bwo
is dependent on the predominant thought that you have.
Yesigama ku kirowoozo ekisinga okuba ekyamaanyi mu bulamu bwo.
And we say that you can pray and fast.
Era ne tugamba nti osobola okusaba n'osiiba.
But if your thought life is not good.
Naye ng'obulamu bwo oba endowooza yo bwetaaga.
A word can be given to you, a prophetic word can be given to you.
Ekigambo eky'obunnabbi kiyinza n'okuweebwa.
But if your thought life is not good.
Naye ng'obulamu bwo oba endowooza yo bwetaaga.
You will still not realize what God has said.
Era togenda kulaba Katonda ky'ayogedde.
Because see it from Abraham.
Bwe kirabire ku Ibrahim.
God spoke to him.
Katonda yayogera naye.
He moved by faith.
N'atambula
n'okukiriza. The word of God was available.
Ekigambo ne kibeerawo.
But his thought life was not good.
Naye nga endowooza ye bwe birowoozo tesibye.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Even after chapter 15.
Ne bw'osomoka ku musumba.
When you go to chapter 16.
Bw'ogenda y'omukumi n'omukaaga.
He got another person's thought life.
Nti aleetera ebirowoozo eby'omuntu omulala.
That was his wife's way of thinking.
Nti era y'engeri y'omukyala we gye yali alowooza.
And that was not what God was saying.
Ng'ekyo Katonda tekyaliko.
But the wife said.
Naye omukyala ono n'agamba.
Now that years are going.
Naye emyaka nga gigenderedde.
I have my maid here.
Nti nze nnina omuddu wange.
Remember I said.
Jukira nagamba.
That wherever you are.
Nti wonna gwe
if you're not careful.
Bw'otegendereza.
The thinking pattern of the people you stay with.
Emitendera gy'ebirowoozo by'abantu abakuliraanye.
Will derail you. or will strengthen you. So the wife began to talk to Abraham.
As she talked,
eventually he saw that there was a possibility of having a child with the maid from his mind. And he went ahead and implemented it. And out came Ishmael. And remember when God was saying, send Ishmael away. Abraham said, I thought this was going to be my heir. Because he's my child. And God said, no, that was not what I was telling you. A man of faith, a man with the word, but the thinking pattern. In chapter 17, God comes around and says, Abraham, walk before me and be perfect. He said, you are meandering too much. Hallelujah. His thought pattern was still a problem. So we looked on many things about the thought pattern. But I wanted to emphasize this other one, which we ended with. Jeremiah 19:11. You know, we know the scripture, some of us by heart. But I gave three different versions on that scripture. King James says, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace are not of evil, to give you an expected end. Jeremiah 29:11. The net translation. For I know what I have planned for you, says the Lord. I have plans to prosper you, not to harm you. I have plans to give you a future filled with hope. Then the ISV says, for I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans for well-being and not for calamity, in order to give you a future and a hope. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And when I went back home, I felt God wanted us to use this as a prayer point. For whatever month you will take. And get all these three different renderings. Because they bring the different aspects of this scripture. There is peace. There is prosperity. There is well-being. Hallelujah. There is no evil. There is no harm. And there is no calamity. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now I want us to use this. And if you can, and I pray you do. And let's pray. And as you pray for yourself, you pray for the church. You pray for whatever you need to pray for. But remember, God says, these are the thoughts. This is what I'm seeing. Your life is a life of peace. Your life is a life of peace. It's not for evil. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your life is to prosper. It's not for harm. Your life is well-being. It's not for calamity. And we declare, because there are plans that the enemy has, and those plans are supposed to bring you down and cause the word of God not to be of effect in your life. But we're going to hold these scriptures plus any other scripture. Brethren, let me tell you, I want to emphasize, take this as a prayer point. And pray as you pray for yourself, pray for your family, pray for your community, pray for the church, pray for the nation, pray that there shall be peace, no calamity, no evil, no work of the enemy shall prevail. There are plans that you have set forth, but God is determined to cause those plans to fail, but we have to partner with him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So that's what I wanted to emphasize. Mark that. Mark that. So today we are still looking at the same scriptures. The word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision and said, I am your shield and exceedingly great reward. Today I'm going to talk about I am your shield and exceeding great reward. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Stiva,
I am your shield. An exceeding great reward. Any other thing followed. Basing on the declaration that God gave. All that Abraham said, you know, I have no child. It was based on this. Because he was quiet. Until God opened his mouth and said, I am your shield and exceeding great reward. We are going to define two words. Not, I'm just going to use what my understanding is. These days we don't use shields. But when you read the scriptures, if you are to go to war, a shield was a very important instrument that a soldier had to have. Hallelujah. It's an instrument of war. And it's an instrument of defense. It acts as a barrier. When the enemy is throwing the arrows or whatever it is, it acts as a barrier. So that when you are behind that shield, you are safe. You were on target. But the shield protected you. The enemy did not miss it. But the shield will protect you. The thing which was coming was with full force. But the shield will keep you safe. Hallelujah. There are arrows that the enemy throws and they are on target. So God came to Abraham and said, I am your shield and your exceeding great reward. Hallelujah. And reward, what you are given as an appreciation for an outstanding performance or a notable action. Reward is an appreciation given to you for an outstanding performance or notable action. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You have seen people are given medals just to recognize them. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I'm going to talk about these two. And I want us to have this mind. God wants us to understand that the day you got born again, God took full responsibility of your life. The day you got born again. And I pray that we do not frustrate the commitment of God to your life. He took full responsibility. I remember in Genesis chapter 12, God had called
Abraham.
He was moving, walking from place to place. And this time he headed to Egypt. And the Bible says, he looked at himself and looked at his wife and said, we are only two. And I don't know what those people are thinking. I see you are very beautiful. Now when we reach there, say that you are my sister. At least I will be safe for your sake. Hallelujah. I will be safe for your sake. So that's what happened. They reached Egypt. The Bible says she was fair. You know, when the Bible says she was fair, she was really fair. So in your imagination, you can see somebody who is really beautiful, who is an attraction. And you know, they were not the only ones going to Egypt. There were many other people going there. But this one, there was something about this person. Do you know, before God, you are so beautiful and attractive. Hallelujah. And he's concerned about you. Don't look at yourself and think I am nothing. No, you have a wrong mind. You are looking at yourself with the wrong eyes, with the wrong specs. See yourself properly. Abraham looked at his wife and said, you are beautiful. Hallelujah. And the Bible says you are the church of Christ. You are the wife of Christ. And so before God, you are beautiful. You know, Sarah did not say, I'm not beautiful. So I'm not going to say, No, she had believed and said, you are true. So I believe you are saying the truth. I am really beautiful. Hallelujah. That one gave her a certain way of composure. When you know who you are,
There is a way you compose yourself. There is a way you walk. There is a way you look at things. There is a way you posture yourself. So she was really a sight to reckon. Sure enough, the people came and wanted her. And off they took her. Abraham never kicked. He never protested. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are even not told that he prayed. But the Bible says that God came around. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God came around and tormented the Egyptians and tormented the priests and tormented them until they began to say there is something wrong. We have been living at peace in this place. Everything is a constant. The only variable here, the only difference here is this lady here. I think this is where our problem is. Hallelujah. And God said, you are right. Don't ever touch that lady. Hallelujah. So God defended. Remember, a shield is an instrument. It's a protective gear. So God came and protected this man. Many things would have happened, but God came and protected him. So when now in chapter 15, God declares and says, this man is walking, does not understand. Hallelujah. Just like many of us, you don't understand that you are covered. You are protected. God is on your life. God is surrounding you. God's life is covering you. God's presence is covering you. Wherever you shall be, you must have that as your mentality. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Don't say I am just an alien here.
You know,
this is not where I'm born. No. You have God. So long as Abraham had God, everything was fine. God told him, you are. I am your shield. Many years ago, I remember I was going to Soroti. I boarded this bus and I began to pray in tongues. I prayed in tongues for the most of the journey. Then when we reached
Tororo,
the word of the Lord came to me and said, you could knock a train. And I there's no Luganda word for train. It's called what?
Gali Omuka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Stiba Chimudi.
God spoke to me and said, you could knock a train.
Katonda na yogera jendi nangamba mwali
tomera
gali ya muka.
At a place where the railroads cross these roads that we use for
Iranga,
cars.
Tuliranye orugudo nekubolia ye gali omuka.
So I looked to the left.
When natunula
I looked to the right.
Kono,
I could see no
radio, nganze siraba yo gali ya muka yonna.
Maybe I did not hear properly. So I continued to read the book I was reading. 2 kilometers down the road, I saw people were seated in front of the bus. I was at the middle. People who were there were running behind.
Abantu abali eyo nga
badate
maliga.
Has the boat bus caught fire? Was the problem? Only to lift up my eyes like this, I saw a train coming. And we are also heading to the same place. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know they were grown up trees and so on, so the bus driver could not see properly. And you know the trains don't stop on the way just like that. So it was us to stop. But our bus was going at a very high speed. And it had rained. So the man tried to put on the brakes and the bus was just sliding. So people were there moving. People were running backwards. At least if it's cars in front, I will be safe behind. So I just sat there. Then I remembered the word. I had such great peace.
Hallelujah.
I had such great peace that eventually God gave this bus driver wisdom and just swung the bus to the bush. So we went to the bush and that place was soggy. So the bus just sank and the train passed. training
just at the same moment. Now when the bus stopped, people were flying through the window. I was wondering, what's the problem with it?
Hallelujah.
God had already seen it and had already said, I'm going to protect you.
Hallelujah.
I don't know whether there are many believers in that
place,
but at least for my sake, hallelujah, for my sake, I was covered. He was a shield. He protected me from the accident.
It
was to destroy my life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If God could open your eyes and you see how many plants, how many arrows which have been on target, when you're in that house, when you were walking on the road, wherever you have been, if God opened your eyes, you would get so scared. But God has covered you up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want us to have that our mentality. He said, Abraham, I am your shield and exceeding great reward. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where you are going, the years that are coming by, you are going to be tormented in your mind. You are going to be tormented physically. But I have told you now that I am your shield. I am your shield. I have seen the future. I have seen what is coming. I am declaring to you, I am your shield. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey!
Hallelujah!
Glory to God! You wake up in the morning and say, God, I thank you because you are my shield. Hallelujah!
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 Remember, the enemy throws the arrows
and they are on target.
Hallelujah!
They are on
target. He's not missing. Thank God! Hallelujah! He said, I myself, the maker of heaven and earth, is going to be there. I am not sending an angel. I am going to be there myself. I am your shield,
an
exceeding great reward. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Glory to God! Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse
29.
The Bible says,
Bible
yegamba, happy are you, O Israel.
Who
is like to you?
Ani alinga mwe.
All people saved by the Lord.
Mwabantu abalokolebwa Katonda.
The shield of your help. Hallelujah.
Oyengabo yobuyambi bwa.
Happy are you.
Agamba nga muline sanyu mwe.
Deuteronomy 33:29.
Ekyamateeka 3:23. Ntinga muline sanyu.
Have you seen people waking up in the morning?
Waliona byekaba golokoka kumacha ngabanyika.
They are going to sleep.
Bagenda kwebaka.
And they are gloomy.
Ngabanyika de.
The writer says,
nti omuwandisi
wa nanga, Israel,
nti nga muli basanyu mwe
Israeli,
ani alinga mwe, ani alinga mwe, ani ayinzo gira gira nisiba kumwe, waliwe chibalike echo muwendo.
Hallelujah.
Nti mute kwa kuba
nesanyu,
mute kwa kujaguzanga, mute kwa kujaguzanga, kubanga temuli ingabadi
abalala,
kubanga mwalo kule wakatondono, mwanu nuli wakatondono.
Hallelujah. You are a shield of help.
Kubanga yengabo yobuyambi bwa mwe.
And who is a sword of excellence?
Erango yoye chechitara echo kuyita.
And he says, and your enemies shall be found liars. Hallelujah.
Jeraba abrabe ba mwe bana asangi bwanga bebalinga.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you understand?
Ontegete.
He said, happy are you?
Agambi engamu line sanyu.
And then he gives you the reasons why you should be happy. He said, you have been saved by this God.
Nagamba mwalo kolebwa Katonda ono.
He says, it's your help.
Ntiye muyambi wa mwe.
It's a shield of your help.
Era yengabo yobuyambi wa mwe.
He says, you should be happy.
Nagamba mulina kubana
sanyu. He says, your enemy shall be found liar.
Nagamba barabe ba mwe bana
sanyu. Do you know when the enemy comes to you?
Obadoma nyinti omulabe wa
tajo. And speaks to your mind.
Na yogere riendo
ozayo. And says, his power is going to kill you. No, the Bible says, happy are they.
Bible
because the enemy shall be found a liar. Why? Because God will defend you.
Kubanga
he will not allow poverty to destroy you. Hallelujah. When the enemy comes and says this sickness is going to kill you, the Bible says, now that God is a shield of your help, then they will be found liars. Hallelujah. He will be found a liar.
Sitani ye mulimba.
He said, it shall not destroy me. God will protect me. God will deliver me. He is my shield. He is my help. He is my deliverer. They shall be found liars. Hallelujah. Whatever area of your life, the Bible says your enemy shall be found a liar. Shall be found a liar. Why? Because God is your shield. God is your shield. God is your shield. Come in there. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. In Exodus chapter 14. Let me just give you an account. God already made the children of Israel get out of the hands of
Pharaoh.
So when the children of Israel were relaxing and saying, now we are going, then they saw the enemy coming. There was a great dust in the sky. And somebody said, Pharaoh has changed his mind. And
he's
coming for you. People began to panic. People began to say all kinds of words. And that's how we normally behave. You think you are safe. Then you see something.
Assemblies
of the bondage that you were in.
Assemblies
of something that is coming to grip you, which you used to be there. And you begin to panic. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But the Bible says, God decided to send a demarcation. He said, enemy are coming. Those are my people. But I'm going to put a demarcation here. So that cloud, the Bible says, it moved from in front and came behind. Hallelujah. I said, there's danger behind. When he put my shield here, he put himself there on the side of the Egyptians. It was thoroughly dark on the side of Israel. It was
thoroughly
bright. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You tell yourself, where is this thing which is chasing me? I thought by this time I would be dead. Hallelujah. But you don't know that the maker of heaven and earth, who is your shield, put the shield there. He placed himself there and cut off the enemy. He wants to come, he can't come. He wants to destroy, he cannot. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And you rejoice in the light. 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 When you see assemblies of things that used to be and want to come back, rejoice in the light. Rejoice in the light. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Glory to God.
Stiwa chimudire mukama.
Rejoice in the light.
Jaguliza mchitanga.
They were enjoying the light.
Jaguliza
the enemy was in darkness.
Omulabe yali
mchizikiza. They could not move forward.
Nebata sobola genda maso.
Until God did what he needed to do.
Okutusanga katonda akoze chayagala.
Let me tell you. Whatever is pursuing you, whatever is following you, whatever is pursuing you, by the authority of the word of God, I want to declare that this day is cut off.
It
is cut off.
It
is cut off.
It
is cut off. It shall not follow you up. It shall not follow you by the authority of the word of God. Hallelujah. Hey! Hallelujah!
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 Oh, hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
The sickness was there 5 years.
It's creeping
again. No! Say no!
Gamba,
you were punished before.
Gamba,
and you cannot come anymore. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
The luck which was there before,
Kubange,
it's coming back again. Say no. No. Because God is my shield. Have that mentality. Don't say this thing has come again. No. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He is trying to pursue. He is trying to control. He is trying to take you back. When the souls of yesterday, when they want to come back and cripple you, say no. God will put a shield.
Katonda yengabo yange.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is your shield of help.
Engabo yange eyobuyambi bwange.
And they will be found liars.
Era Satani anazuli bwanga
mulimba.
Ekitibwa kidire
katonda. That's why Psalms 115.
Chovola ba Zaburi 10:15.
Verse 9 up 11.
Olunyiri olwomwendo okutuka ku 10.
Oh Israel, trust in the Lord.
Agamba, Israeli mwesige katonda. Kubanga ye muyambi. Era ye ngabo yo.
Oh house of Aaron, trust in the Lord.
Kwe nyumba ya Aroni, wesige katonda.
He is your help.
Kubanga ye muyambi.
And shield.
Era ye ngabo yo.
You.
Gwe.
You.
Gwe.
That fear the Lord.
Gwatia katonda.
Trust in the Lord.
Wesige katonda.
He is your help.
Kubanga ye muyambi.
And shield. Hallelujah.
Era ye ngabo yo.
That's why the psalmist has to say like
that. Ba muwandisi wa Zaburi bwa yogete.
Psalms 115.
Zaburi 10:15.
From verse 1 and to 11.
Okutuka okulunyiri olusoko
tukwa kulwongo. Now that God is that kind of person.
Katonda bwa banga bwati
bwali. He said put your trust in him.
Nga kugambye nti obwesige bwo buteke
mu katonda. Put your trust in him.
Obwesige bwo buteke mu katonda.
Now he is that kind of person.
Era ye katonda bwa.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be his name.
Erinnya lye liweebwe ekitiibwa.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Kitiibwa kimuddire Katonda.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says, Sela, think about it.
Bible egamba, kirowoozeeko.
Now I'm going to look at some of the scriptures that make us very active participants of what God is doing.
Ebitufuula okubeera abantu abeetaba ennyo mu ekyo Katonda kyakola.
Second Chronicles chapter 16 and verse 9.
Ebyomu mirembe ekyokubiri sule y'omukaaga.
The Bible says.
Bible egamba.
The eyes of the Lord run through.
Amaaso ga Katonda gayita mu nsi yonna.
To show himself strong.
Okusobola okumulaga ng'ow'amaanyi.
On behalf of those whose hearts are perfect.
Ku lwabo abalina emitima egituukiridde.
Oh, who are committed.
Oba abo abeewaddeyo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I read somewhere.
Ninawe nasoma.
Where it said.
Nga wagamba.
God always acts.
Katonda ekiseera kyonna akola.
On the 11th hour, it's not scripture.
Nti ye akola ku ssaawa eri yennyini
eyeetaagibwa. Nti
oyo yalaba embeera naye n'ajjira mu ssaawa ye
ey'obwetaavu.
Nti bwewaawo ajjira mu biro.
When you think.
Gwe w'olowooleza.
It's too late.
Nti oba oli awo
kikeereza. These are some of the things that the enemy uses.
Bino by'ebintu ebimu Sitaani by'akozesa.
To derail us from our trust.
Okusobola okutuggyamu obwesige.
Because God does not behave like the way you behave.
Kubanga Katonda ye teyeeyisa nga mmwe ate.
God is outside time.
Katonda ali wabweru wa budde.
And as you are counting the minutes.
Gwengo bw'obala eddakiika.
As you are counting days. Those things don't exist in God. They exist in here on earth. So don't use your calendar. Don't use your watch. And determine whether God is a shield. Or
is
not a shield. Don't. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say God is looking. Looking.
Atunula.
To see.
Okulaba.
This kind of person who knows.
Omuntu ono amanyi.
That God is my shield.
Ti Katonda ye ngabo ye.
There are times when God will do things without our knowledge.
Waliwo ebiro Katonda bw'anaakola ebintu nga.
And he has done that many times.
Emirundi egisinga
bw'akikola. But God also wants us to do something.
Naye ng'oluusi ayagala naffe tubeeko kye tukola.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He wants us to send a word.
Ayagala naffe tutume kigambo.
He wants us to operate in faith.
Ayagala tukolere mu kukkiriza.
Because the Bible says without faith it is
kubanga
impossible.
Kubanga Bible egamba nti awatali kukkiriza kizibu musanyusa.
So that's why.
Chovola ba.
He is looking.
Atunula.
Council Najera is looking.
Aje Najera.
Council Kajansi is looking.
Aja.
I say, is there anybody who really understands who I am?
Kwe wali wantegera wano.
So when we are those kind of persons.
Bwe tunabeera abantu bwe bati.
We'll always see the hand of God. We'll always see the hand of God. Look at the Hebrew boys in
Daniel.
They first made a statement. We shall not bow to that image. They told them. If you don't bow, you are going to burn. They said, we don't mind. But what we know, our God. So the
portions
of God being their shield.
Say,
our God whom we serve shall deliver us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Our God whom we serve shall deliver us. We have walked with him a number of years. We have seen how faithful he is. We have seen how he is mindful of us. And therefore we are not scared of the threats that you have. The fire is real. Your threats are also real. But you have something better. We have God who is greater than all your threats and all that fire. And do you know? The people who heard them, the fellow Jews and other sympathizers, were praying that these people do not get thrown into the fire. Because they knew if you go there, you're dead. So everybody was praying. Everybody was praying. Praying to the president. And people, Rika, Sika, Baya, Laha, Riba, Baya, Haya. And people are praying.
Said,
pray.
Musabe.
Pray.
Musabe banange.
It's going to be tomorrow.
Ntio erencha.
No fast. No eating.
Teri kulya banange.
Let's fast.
Uganda tusibeko.
And then the guys are bound.
Abasajja nga bali eri.
Hallelujah. The guys are bound.
Abamube waddeyo.
And they got strong men.
Ne baleta abasajja abamanyi ne babasiba.
Let me tell you. Just imagine if you are one of the fellows praying. Umitirizanga
gwo omukwa aba abasaba.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You have been praying. You are believing God. You are trusting God is doing this thing. You have never seen him fail. But this time the flames are thrown to the fire. You know when they went full and the flames went up. When something which is cold lands onto fire, the flames go up. Isn't it so? So these guys landed like this and the flame went up because they are finished.
Hallelujah.
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 Now, why didn't God stop these people from being thrown into the fire?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God is not limited by any physical anything
Katona
here on earth. So when you are believing God for something, when you are trusting God for something, the physical elements that you see, the time that is moving on, whatever else is around about your life, is not a determinant whether God will come through for you or not. Hallelujah. They were thrown into the fire. But did he protect them? Yes. Did he become their shield? Yes. They were in the fire. They came out. There was no smoke. There was no nothing in them. What happened? The one whose word does not fail. And is the one speaking to you now. I am your shield. I am your shield. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Whether you are moving along the edge, never remove your trust. By the Spirit of God, I'm praying we shall hold on. I say, God, I'm holding on. Hallelujah. They got thrown. Glory to God. What about John chapter 11? Lazarus. And the sisters. Jesus went on a preaching mission. And then the word found him there. The one you love is sick. And if you don't act fast, he will be dead. And the Bible says he had it. Then he stayed there another 2 days. Can you imagine? Hallelujah. I prayed. And I really felt I knew God had had it. Then the next day, there is nothing. Another day, there is nothing. And then we revert back to unbelief. No! No! In the name of Jesus, we shall stand our ground. In the name of Jesus, we refuse to move. In the name of Jesus, we refuse to be discouraged. In the name of Jesus, we'll keep moving forward. We'll keep believing. Hallelujah. Irrespective of how the enemy is breathing. Lazarus dies.
Lazaro nafa.
And they say it's gone. It's over.
Never gamba.
It's over. Then they heard that the master is around the corner. Mother runs. and say, if you had been here.
Ne balyoka bammaliza n'alyoka mugamba singa wabadde wano.
And Jesus said,
Yesu n'agamba,
don't you know who I am? Hallelujah.
Tomanyi kyendi.
I'm the resurrection and the life. Don't you know who I am? If you think time has passed, if you think things are on, if things now they are gone, let me tell you, he is the resurrection and the life. Whatever was, it can still be in the name of Jesus. I know that people know. He can change things. He can put life back again. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. He can put life back again. And the Bible says, he said, where have you placed him? He didn't say, where have you put the body? He just said, where have you put him? He's still alive. Hallelujah. 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 The enemy wants you to refer to things as the dead, the gone,
the things
of last year. If the dream is a dream, if it's a call, whatever God has put, he is not dead, he's still alive. He's still alive. Where have you put him? Where have you put it? Where have you put a dream? He's still alive. Hallelujah. And just comes around and says, remove the stone. Say, you don't know. I believe that I stopped believing a long time ago. Hallelujah. There are some people now, some areas are no-go areas. No, I believe that that one is no longer an area for me. Jesus said, didn't you hear me say, I am the resurrection and the life. There are people here who have thrown away what they know God had put in their hearts some years ago. And you said, I believe God, I see nothing. Let me tell you, this is a word for you. This is a word for you. This is a word for you. He is the resurrection and the life. He shall come alive. He will come alive. He will come alive. He will come alive. He will come alive. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Makatele marahaya. You come alive. And sure enough, say, Lazarus, you come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. However bad the situation seems to be. But if this God is still sitting on the throne, and who is? He is on the throne.
He
will never leave the throne. He is still in charge. Your life can turn around. Your life can turn around. Your life can turn around. Glory to God. You know, there is a song sung by a number of people, but I like the version that Karen kept.
Karen,
she's called Karen what? Karen somebody. But she's Karen. The other name has gone. She was singing about this John chapter
11.
I say, when we say it's 4 days late, because they told him he's 4 days dead. He said, when they say it's 4 days late, but to God is still on time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have you heard that song? He's still on time. For you, it was supposed to be 4 days ago. But for him, he's still on time. For you, it's supposed to be last year. But to him, he's still on time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Never, never get disappointed and discouraged to the point that you are paralyzed in life. When you can move on with life and believe God and trust God, and God is your shield, he will protect you. Will protect your dignity. Will protect your future. He's protecting your desires. He's there for you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Remember in the story of Saul and Samuel.
Jukira mu lugero lwa Saulo ne Samuel.
Samuel told Saul,
Saulo agamba,
there is going to be war.
Samuel agamba Saulo, you are going
to the battlefield.
Ogenda
but wait for me until I come. Saul waited.
Saulo
and waited. The 7 days got finished. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And Saul said, now it's over. Even his own people said it.
Do something.
Haven't people told you do something?
Hallelujah.
Do something. You are told to do something you are not authorized to do.
No gambi wokukola gwate chotalina kukola.
You are told to get involved in something that the scriptures don't allow
no
you to
gambi
do.
Wa okweta ba muchintu nga gweto gwani
de. They're encouraging you to cut corners.
Bakuzamu amanyo oteme.
They're encouraging you to take shortcuts. And the scriptures say you should not.
Ngebya wandiki wa pyo
say wait, there's a time.
No.
I am coming.
Akugamba linda nzija.
Then Saul decided to shortcut. And the Bible says immediately finished Samuel. He said, you have done a foolish thing, and God was very annoyed. Hallelujah. How many of us have been encouraged to take shortcuts? Whether a shortcut to relationships, whether shortcuts to finance, whether shortcuts to whatever, because there is a pressure. At this time, it should be this. At this time you should be doing this. There is a pressure and you feel like you are left alone. Then you say, let me take this shortcut. If God spoke to you, God is your shield. He will protect your dignity. He will protect who you are. He will protect your destiny. He will protect what belongs to you. He is your shield. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Don't be pressurized. Don't be pressurized. You will take a move and you regret why you took that move. It cost him the kingdom. Just because he thought God had delayed.
Ye yalowooza nti Katonda aluddewo.
He thought this time God is not true to his word.
N'agamba ku mulundi guno Katonda teyeyi.
But we know the story. Samuel appeared.
Naye tumanyi olugero nti
Samuel yalabika. And say you have acted foolishly.
N'amugamba okoze bubi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Kitiibwa kimuddire Mukama.
What is there?
Ki ekiriyo?
In your life.
Mbulamu bwo.
That makes you think.
Gwe kikulowoozesa.
Now it's done.
I want you to know.
God, he said, God came to Abraham.
I am your shield.
And I'm your exceeding
strength.
I want us to believe those words. It's not Abraham, it's me. He's talking to me. I am your shield. I am your exceeding great reward. Psalms 18 verse 35.
Zaburi 18:35.
Psalms
18:35.
You have also given me a shield of your salvation.
Era nango mbadde ngabe y'obulokozi bwo.
Did you know that salvation is a defense? He said, you have given me a shield of your salvation. Salvation is a defense. And many of us are playing around with salvation. And you don't know it is a defense. If it was not for salvation, you would end up in hell. 100%. Hallelujah. But God has put salvation as a defense. All the plans of the wicked would have arrived on target. But because you are saved, salvation is a defense. You would have been with wrong men and women around about your life. But because you are saved, salvation is a defense. He's protecting you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You would have walked into a wrong place. But because you are saved, salvation is a defense. Hallelujah. He said, you have also given me a shield of salvation. Salvation is a defense. In your life, salvation is not to be played around with. It's not something you just talk about.
It's a weapon. It's a weapon. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you know some people just hear that you are saved and they take off? They know that it's a no-go area. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's a defense. Psalms 5 and verse 12. For you, O Lord, will bless the righteous with the favor you will compass with. Will compass him about as with a shield. According to this scripture, he says, according to God, favor is a shield. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You say, favor is a shield. Favor is a shield. You rise up every morning. I am the favored of the Lord. Because it is a shield, it will protect you. It will safeguard you. It will do everything that needs to be done. The Bible says, Jesus grew in the favor of God and the favor of man. Because favor is a shield. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's a weapon of defense. The enemy will throw arrows. But favor is a weapon of defense. The Bible says in Acts chapter 7 and verse 9 to 11. Acts 7, 9 to 10. And the patriarchs moved with envy. The patriarchs moved with envy. That's the brothers of Joseph. Sold Joseph into Egypt. But God was with him. And verse 10 says like this. And delivered him out of his afflictions. And gave him favor and wisdom in the sight of Pharaoh. Hallelujah. How did he deliver him from affliction? By giving him favor and wisdom. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's how he survived. When he appeared before Pharaoh, the favor of God was upon this young man. And instead of saying, well done, you have given me the interpretation of the dream. You have also given me the way out. Now send him back to the dungeon. No, favor spoke and said, no. This is the favor of the Lord. He is supposed to be in prison. But the favor became a defense. He gave him favor as a defense. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All the afflictions. All the afflictions. All the envy. All the hatred.
No,
but when the favor of God is upon your life, it is a defense. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, it is a defense. 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 Other people will speak for you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God will organize the right people to talk on your behalf.
It
is a defense. They will favor you. When we are looking for where to build, we went to this place where we are now. We saw the land. And then we negotiated. The old man said, give me this amount of money now. We told him, we don't have the money, but we like the land. So we shall, you keep the land. In 2 weeks we shall come with the money. That was a statement of faith, by the way. Hallelujah. Because we went to look for the land without money. In fact, some of our friends were laughing at us, you people. They don't do things like that. You first have some money, then you go looking for the land. Say, no, we feel a stirring in our hearts.
Now,
the old man said, there is somebody who is offering me more money than we have agreed. But I just like you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You say, I just like that man. What was that? That was the favor. It became a defense for me. When I did not have the money, it defended me. Let God be your defense. Wherever you shall be, let God be your defense. Let favor speak for you. Let other people speak for you. Let something happen in your life. Hallelujah.
Favor.
Favor. Favor. Favor. Every day. Favor. Before men. Favor. Before God. Favor. Hey. Hey, shake it, Malahaya. They'll look at you and say, I like that man. I like that lady. I just want to bless this lady. I don't know why. I don't know why. I just want to bless her. Favor will get defense. When they say you'll be sleeping hungry, but favor will get defense. God will rally people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said he was delivered from all his afflictions. By favor, hallelujah. By favor. By favor. By favor. Say, I'm favored. I am favored. I am favored. I am favored. Of God. I am favored of men. Wherever I go, the favor of God is upon my life and shall defend me, shall protect me, shall safeguard me. Favor. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey! Makata malasakaya malehesia. Yes, favor. Favor.
Favor.
In the morning, favor. Need the favor. Night time, favor. 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 It's upon me. It's upon my life. Wherever I go, favor is with me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey! Favor. Oh, favor. You don't have to work for everything. Favor. 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 You don't have to have all the knowledge.
Favor.
You don't have to have the strength.
Favor.
Favor. Hey! Makata malahasika baya hasile baba. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Let's just rise up and thank God. Let's rise up and thank God. Makata malahasika telele baba baba. Roko soko telele lele baba raha santa raba. Ima soka maya halile baba raha siye baba. Raka baba 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 baba. Reko mahendele hendele le baba raka saya. Oh, glory. Oh, glory. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As you're still standing, let me say this last one. You will not be sitting, but you will be standing. Because you have conquered everything, the other thing we shall conclude another time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In Ruth chapter 2 and verse 13, the Bible says Ruth spoke to Naomi. Let me go to the field where I shall find favor. Hallelujah. Oh, let me go to the field where I shall find favor. I don't want to go to a field where there is no favor. I want to go to a field where there is a favor. Let me go to a place where I shall find favor. Direct me, O God. I should go to a place where I shall find favor. Let me go. Let me go. Let me go. Hallelujah. Then she began to move and go say, I have found somebody who understands. And she went and landed in Boaz's field and began like everybody else. She was not the only one cleaning. She was an outsider among the people, the owners. And as she was there, the man appears. Did not ask about anybody else, but began to ask about who is this one. Why? Because favor was speaking. Favor was speaking. Favor was speaking. Favor was speaking. Who would have talked to somebody else?
teri mulala yenna.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you think that was the only thing he had to talk about?
Kichokate yalino kwogerako.
He had to talk about many things.
Yalina binje
byokubuza. But because somebody had collected favor.
Nayo okubanga waliwe yaliye yunze
kuganja. Favor collected her.
Okuganja ne kumuyunga.
And she came and said, who is this?
Nagamba anyono.
Who is this?
Anyono.
He said, this is so and so.
Nebagamba ono yebu.
The man said, let me tell you.
Nagamba kankubuza.
Don't ever touch her. Don't ever rebuke her. Make her give her more. Favor is speaking. Favor is speaking. Somebody here. Somebody here. Somebody here. Somebody here. In this week. In this week. Somebody here. In this week. In this week. Supernaturally. 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 Supernaturally
directed.
God,
yes, Rakatele
Heseke Bayahaya. Oh, Rakatele Babarahaya. Hey, favor.
Okuganja.
Favor.
Okuganja.
Say this week.
Gambe no week.
May I find favor.
Nino okuganja.
This week.
Eno week.
May I find favor.
Nino okuganja.
May I find favor.
Dekansango
okuganja. May I find favor.
Isango okuganja.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oshakata malahara hasika ya mama. Rekete bebebebebe. Lehendelele baba sika ya mama. Oh.
Hey.
Rekete melehendelele masaya. Favor delivered her from her afflictions. Favor protected her from starvation. Favor got her out of poverty. Maka sakatala marahaya. Hey, maka tele marahosia baba. Oh, reke telele baba mahandala makuria baba. We give you thanks. We give you praise. Yeko temele hariba ya haya. Raka baba 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 baba. Hey!
We believe this message has blessed you. For more information, please visit our website, Destiny Life Family Church, where you will be able to have access to more of our materials, audios, videos, and information on our church programs. Don't forget to like and subscribe to His Voice YouTube channel to stay updated on our latest videos. Click the notification bell to receive notifications whenever our video is uploaded. Thank you.